What is up, guys? Link's Warlord Gaming here, and welcome to episode 53 of Throwback Thursday. Today, I am in Vanquish. Now, the reason that I'm actually playing this game right now is because it was free with gold as one for one of the Xbox 360 games, and I was like, ooh, that looks really cool. I'm probably gonna download that. And so basically what I just assumed this was from the cover, it's probably like either a first or a third person shooter, and it's all like futurized, and there's like a whole bunch of laser guns, and just basically other futuristic stuff. Anyways, this game was released on October 19th, 2010, so as of when I'm recording this, this game is 7 years old, I think. Yeah, 7. Okay, now it doesn't... Just press A. Uh-oh. New game. Uh-oh. Casual.
Vanquish.
Yeah, I've never played this game. Ever, so... That's probably why I'm gonna go do casual.
Sam, how's the view on your monitor?
Looking good. The scenery's a little bland, though.
All right. Let's proceed with functionality testing. We're starting with electro-optical targeting systems calibration.
Sam, I'm going to display a virtual target. Try to follow it visually.
Okay, so I'm just supposed to follow the targets. This is reminding me of the beginning of Halo. You had to look at the,
If things seem backwards, let me know, and I'll adjust the optical nerve sensors.
You know, this is a real pain in the ass. How many times you guys gonna make me do this?
It's important we have baselines, Gideon. Just because you can read a manual doesn't mean you know what you're doing.
Okay. Well, yeah, see, it's probably gonna be a little hard. Fireball aiming at the target. How do I... There we go. Now, yeah, good. There's an ADS. That's good. It's good. I'm not gonna have to fire without aiming. Like that, you don't even have to really aim though. You just kinda have to, press left trigger and then move. And wait till normally. The crosshair is lined up. Then recoil fire.
Sam, your weapon isn't exactly stock.
I know. I'm changing blade modes. Let's try firing something different.
Okay, shotgun. Oh, that's awesome. Yeah, I like how futuristic all the weapons look. Change to weapon 1, weapon 2, weapon 3. Okay, let's try the LMG.
We're still working on expanding a number of configurations stored in memory. You can't just scan whatever you want and have it work. That being said, go ahead and activate the scanner.
Okay, is that what the... Oh, rocket launcher. Oh, great, but there we go. Changing weapons to replace a currently equipped weapon, pick up the same type of weapon, replenishing ammunition. Disc launcher. Are there any other things here? Nope, okay. Oh, that's awesome. Wait, so how do I scan it though? I want to scan it. Place it in blade memory. How do I scan it though? Pick up, just exchange weapon. That's not what I wanted it to do. I want to scan something. Oh my god, okay. See controls? Maybe it opens audio. title. There's just resume game options and title screen. Oh, okay. Upgrade the current chip. Acquiring an upgrade item will upgrade the current weapon via the blade system and increase its effectiveness in various ways. Picking up the same weapon when already carrying the maximum amount of ammunition will allow you to proceed on the upgrade path for that weapon.
This thing is even picking up surface scratches.
Blade can only replicate what already exists, even the imperfections.
Now we're going to check the grenade mounts.
Why? Use grenade, D-pad, change grenade type. Oh no. There we go. Didn't want to blow myself up there. This is effective against large groups of enemies or enemies hiding behind cover. Let's see, let's change grenade type. Oh, it's like a, an EMP. EMP emitter will temporarily disable this target from moving for a limited period of time. Alright, okay. Close quarters. Probably do close quarters and then
we
the
need to
AR
get some
mode.
Data on how far we can push the actuators.
I'm releasing an object to test your impact force.
Our friends at the Pentagon were happy to lend us a brand new piece of equipment. Electromagnetic armor. Punch it as much as you'd like, Sam.
B melee attack.
Confirming electromagnetic reaction. Sam, give the electromagnetic engine generating the reaction force a second to cool.
So we can't hit the thing too quick, huh?
Go ahead and punch it again.
Okay, execute a melee attack and destroy the electromagnetic barrier. Alright, got it.
Nothing beats the old 1-2.
Looks like you've still got some bite in you, Sam.
Execute and destroy. Okay, do I have to destroy the other one? Melee attacks depend on your currently equipped weapon. Each has its own merits, so experiment to find the best suited to the situation. Wow, that was quick. Alright, AR mode.
Sam, we took the measurements we made of your brain's sympathetic nervous system and tuned the R's suit synaptic emitters to augment your reactions under fire.
Doesn't really make walking around with electrodes all day any more comfortable.
Small price to pay for having elevated synaptic activity during critical fight-or-flight situations.
Will you two quit bickering like a couple of MIT grad students? Now let's proceed with our test of the R's functionality. Let me know when you're ready, Sam.
Start, okay, yeah.
Okay.
Oh, wait, oh. What? Can I fire the gun, please? Please, can I fire the gun? Okay, I can roll with A. Like, am I supposed to Tanker code kind of destroy? Trigger AR mode until your suit overheats, allowing you to react to it.
I finished implementing the manual trigger system.
Yeah, I can't even get over there to melee
it. The system will automatically
lock. So why can't I fire my freaking gun?
Any life-threatening imbalances in your hormonal levels due to extended use.
Wait, during evade, trigger activate AR mode. Evade. Oh, and it like stop. Oh, that's awesome. Like, stops time. Oh, then it runs out. Okay, now I can fire on the target while manually trigger. Oh my god. Okay, did I get it that time? It's not telling me if I passed or failed. Okay, and then evade. There we go. Air mode will allow you to intercept attacks such as missiles, however, like boost. This mode will overheat your suit, so use it wisely. Alright, I think that's all the tutorials I need. Go ahead and exit the tutorial.
Very well. I think that's enough for today's test.
Good job, Sam.
That little workout made me hungry. You up for some lucky?
Director Shinzo. Okay, I can't. I'm not even gonna try. Producer at sushi. Art director Noaki. Why does everyone that make this game have really hard to pronounce names? Character designer. Story writer Hiroki Kato. You know, I'm not even gonna try any of them. But from now on, because I'm just gonna end up butchering the names, no matter how hard I try. Oh boy. They coordinated a missile? Or is it like a laser? I think it's a laser. San Francisco. Yeah, you might want to run. I wouldn't just stand there, I'd run. So, yep, that's why I said you should run. You see a giant red laser come up from the sky, and you just stand there? Like, seriously? Oh, it's like turning everyone into zombies. Alright, so it turns out this game isn't really, like, futuristic with, robotic enemies. It's actually a zombie game. And down there we'll go in the water, and down goes the bridge. They just took out a whole entire section of that bridge. And now they're all looking for survivors.
The Order of the Russian Star now welcomes you to the inauguration of a new Russian state.
What?
My fellow Americans, today has been a day of great tragedy. San Francisco will never be the same. And the toll of our war has increased by countless men, women, and children. Their loss is deeply felt by every American. To those who have committed this heinous act, we say firmly, we will not negotiate with those who wish to destroy us. Our strength is unmatched. Our will resolute. We will be victorious.
And God bless you. Go America.
And God bless the United States of America.
SCO-1 Providence is currently under the control of those responsible for the coup in Moscow.
Is that the same voice actor for Tank Dempsey?
Oh yeah. This is Sam. DARPA sent him to come along with us.
That guy really sounds like the voice actor for Tank Dempsey.
New York for becoming the next San Francisco. Make no mistake. We will stop that from happening.
I might actually look that up later once I'm done recording this. Because
sure
he really sounds like Tank Dempsey.
Don't seem too fond of
DARPA operatives take their orders directly from POTUS.
notice in SecDef. These guys are just interested in marking their territory.
But I mean, but that guy also sounds a little bit like Tank Dempsey. So that was like the Russians? Like they weren't like aliens from outer space?
You know what must be done. We'll get the professor back. This place, hell, even this suit runs on his energy designs. He's too valuable to kill.
I know.
This the toy you've been working on?
Okay, yeah, I'm just gonna go out on a limb here and say that the old guy is definitely Tank Dempsey.
Not even scratched. You did get some training in this thing, right?
Our simulators are very thorough.
Yeah, like the new guy might not be Tank Dempsey, but the old guy is definitely Tank Dempsey. Cigarette cut there.
What the fuck, man?
Going in hard and fast. All units, take the rails.
Well, I mean, he probably wanted to give you
not
some training.
Smoke on the ship.
Okay. Act 1, Mission 1, landing. Okay, can I sprint? Is there a lot of sprinting? Okay, it looks like there is a few sprinting. Nice.
Sam, you need to get to the hangar ASAP.
Alright, yeah. I would do that if I knew how to sprint. The ship, and down goes the other one. That looks like the one ship from Star Wars. The one, Rebel ship, the one that gets, like, fired at by the Stormtrooper ship. It has, like, the six things on the back of it. Episode 4. Oh, are we gonna bust through it? Oh boy. Yeah. Oh wait, I don't think that was our ship. I think that was the Russian ship. I just assumed it was our ship because it was blue. They look like the Covenant from frickin' Halo. Yeah, they totally look like the Covenant from Halo. Oh boy. Okay, that's a lot of bullets. They're firing at it.
Get on board, sir. Ready for real stuff.
Hoorah! Hoorah!
Come on, you wait. We'll live forever.
Okay. ships that look exactly like the one. Save the big ship. Oh no. Oh, it's going down. Mayday, mayday. Oh no, they're gonna get crushed. Yeah, you better get out of the area. And it is now officially crashed. That guy didn't have an energy sword. Or like some sort of sword that looked like an energy sword.
The Martians have complete control of this place.
Okay. Act 1.
That central gate.
So the whole first mission, like this, all sir. It was just me walking somewhere. Wow. Okay, shotgun. Isn't really effective at this range. Grab the LMG.
Yeah.
If you go there, you should be able to flank the enemy from behind.
I mean, these are enemies. Okay, there we go. There's the health bar. Can I see the health bar first?
Get out of the way.
Oh, so I think you have to shoot them in the chest. So that's your form of sprinting. Okay. Okay, and it's also used to like slide under places. There we go. Oh no. Reload. Roll, roll, roll. Is there a way of like taking cover? Okay, it's X. Don't know why it's X. It's like usually A. Other three. Yeah, see, I just saw an energy sword right there. I pick up some shotgun ammo. Take control of the turret and just completely annihilate that guy. Okay, come on, come on. There we go. I have the angle on him. Who's that? Is that a red barrel? Hey, it's an explosive red barrel. Guys from range. Oh god, is that a sniper? I don't know, I just saw a giant red light and it scared me. Okay, oh, come on. Here we go, okay. Change the shotgun. Oh boy. See the landing dock 3. Ooh, that's a really effective shotgun. Can I get on top somewhere? Oh, hello. Yeah. Hello. Hello. Alright, who's next? Nope, okay. And then that's another mission. So the first two missions, they consisted of me walking somewhere and like just going through about maybe like 5 to 8 minutes of combat. Okay, so if the missions are just gonna be like this, then that'll do it for this episode of Throwback Thursday. Oh my god. Like, I hope like, because I might actually play the rest of this game off camera. And I'm just hoping that the missions aren't going to be this short. I just find it funny of how short these missions are, and especially how short and empty the first mission was, because all I had to do was walk somewhere. But anyways, this is Link's Warlord Gaming saying so long, and bye-bye.